If you have an area of your yard, or maybe it's your whole lawn that you want to renovate and finally have a beautiful space, this is the video for you. But this one has a twist, because I renovated my entire lawn without any irrigation, no sprinklers, no hoses. In fact, I never watered this area once. And this video is not just a myth or theory. I'm going to show you the project from beginning to end, and you can judge the final result, but I think you'll be amazed. So let's start with the before shots to show you what I was dealing with. So here's a collection of how bad it was. So this area has never been irrigated, it's never had any ability to have a hose reach it, and it's really been difficult. I call it the Dust Bowl because the area is just basically destroyed. It's filled with crabgrass weeds and it was just a mess, but this was the year I was going to solve it. So what really gave me hope was I met a professional who I was just talking to, and I told him about my situation and he gave me some great pointers. Then I did some internet research and I put it all together and I said, you know what, I think I can do this. So let's just get started. So the very first thing I knew I had to do was to kill the weeds. And I did not want to use Roundup because my fear was if this project was a flop, I didn't want to kill everything in the area because then I would really have absolutely nothing left. So here's some shots as I go through. I'm spraying a product called Tenacity. Now, in my experience, Tenacity is a great product. You can watch my other video for real details on that of how I used it, but Tenacity for me worked great. I spot sprayed the area and it's a very large area, so it was not easy, but I still didn't want to buy more equipment. So I did it by hand, and the first part of this was getting rid of those weeds. So the next thing I chose to do was I aerated the area, and I didn't just do it once, twice, I actually did it four times. And the reason I did that was the soil was very compacted, I've driven on this area a lot, it was just really, really messed up as you could see in those photos. So I aerated it multiple times until it looked pretty good to me. I still missed a few areas, but I didn't really hang up on it because I knew for the most part I was getting most of the area. And I think that was critical because you have to remember, this is a part of my yard that I don't necessarily stare at all the time. So I wanted it to be greatly improved, but I'm not concerned that it necessarily looked like a golf course, especially since I knew I had limited irrigation, or in my case, no irrigation. So I'm in the northeast, and because this area has so heavy of a cover of pine trees, I knew that I needed to lime the area. Remember, for almost 10 years, I've done nothing to this area, so it really was neglected. Lime is cheap, I put it in this broadcast spreader, and I spread about 400 pounds of lime in this area. This area is about 15,000 square feet, but for me, I felt that this was a critical step to prepare the pH of the soil. The next critical part of the process is to discuss seed and timing. And those are really important because remember, you're going to grow this lawn in an area where you're never going to water it and it's not going to have any sort of sprinkler system. So the timing is critical. You want to ideally pick early fall as your time to seed. But that's not the only time you can choose. You can also plant in early spring. And you want to pick a time of year where it's cool out, but we're still going to get some rainfall to get those seedlings started. And that is really critical. Don't undertake this project if it's the middle of summer. You're really going to be doomed to fail. But in those early seasons, I think you're going to have some good results. The next super critical item is the type of seed you use. There's no need to tell you about all kinds of different seed because only one type of seed worked for me and it did the job. This seed was recommended to me as a low water or no water seed and it really fit the bill. So that seed is made by a company called Lesco and it's Teammates Plus. That's exactly what I used and you'll see the results. So now that I knew the timing that I put the seed down and the kind of seed I was going to use, I had to decide how I would do it. So I aerated. So what I did was a little bit of an untraditional approach. I didn't rent a seed slicer. I didn't want to spend any more money. So what I did is I put the seed in my broadcast spreader and I went all around the area. Now lots of those seeds are going to go into the aeration holes. So I knew that would help for sure. So right after I put the seed down, I chose to put down a starter fertilizer, and you want to use a starter fertilizer so that it doesn't burn your seedlings. And starter fertilizers are designed so that that will not happen. I chose to use the Lesco starter fertilizer. It was the Triple 19 product. My end result is excellent, so I'm sure other fertilizers would work fine, but in my case, the Lesco was the product I used and I will continue to use. So now at this point, everything was ready to go, and the next day it actually rained. So it was perfect, and I said, this is great. And then the bad thing happened. It did not rain for the next 8 days. So I said to myself that this is the worst thing that could happen because now the seed got wet, came to life, and it's going to basically die over the next 8 days. So it really was nothing you could do. So I just waited. And what I actually saw was that 8 days later when it rained, slowly but surely, I started to see seedlings and I was really blown away. Now, I did not get 100% germination, and you should not expect that without a controlled water source. Even with a controlled water source, you may not get that kind of germination. But the seedlings started in as little as 7 days, and I was really blown away and quite hopeful, but I still had a long way to go. So as the days continued to go by, I was very excited, but I didn't want to get overly excited because I kept feeling as though the grass was going to just die. But the reality is, it just didn't feel right because I still couldn't water it. And now, as you can see, as we're going up on my mower, I'm going to show you the area 6 weeks after I did all this work, and I really was blown away by the difference. So this is the same area 6 weeks later. It really is an unbelievable difference. So the seedlings came in. The growth has been fantastic, and I have not mowed it or touched it once since I put that down. So this is the exact same area 6 weeks later. Most of the weeds are dead, and it really is a huge improvement, as you can see. So if you're into your lawn like I am, you'll be very excited on a day like this. So again, this is 6+ weeks waiting to be able to cut the grass. Now, I had access to a commercial mower today, so I chose to use that, but you can certainly use any regular mower to do this job. And this is obviously sped up, but I wanted to show you as I started to put some lines in this lawn, which is really unbelievable because this area was a disaster before. All it was a dust cloud when I would mow, and it was a nightmare. Now, this is a fairly damp day, so that obviously has something to do with it too. But this is a huge improvement, and you have to remember that these grass seedlings are still young. There's a lot of fine blades. They still need more time, and they're still going to keep growing until long into November, and then next year they're going to start off right. So I am very pleased with the end result of this. I was very concerned going into this project because I felt like it might be doomed to fail, but the key was the timing and the choice of the seed. So I was very happy that a professional took the time to actually give me some free advice, and it really paid off. So if you believe that you cannot do seed without having irrigation or having a hose to water it, think again. If you time it right and you choose the right products, you will absolutely get a good result. So I wish you the best of luck with your project. I hope this gives you some information that you may never have seen before and let you see real, true results like I have. And I'm going to be enjoying this lawn for hopefully a lot of years to come. So I really appreciate you watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give me a thumbs up and also consider subscribing to my channel. It's free and you'll get to see all my great videos as soon as I release them. Thanks again for watching and have a great day.